out of the depths, I cry to you, oh Lord, hear my prayer with my whole heart. I want to praise you, oh Lord, hear my.
Prayer and meditation of the morning, beginning with prayer for communion and cleansing. God, I bow my life and my heart, my body and my soul, my will and my view, my thoughts and my feelings. Yes, God, I bow my whole being before you, in the simplicity of humble faith, and with the confidence that you call me near. I bow myself in the humility of the fear of the Lord. I bow my life in awe of our great God and Savior. God, please shine your glory and your favor upon me and upon us. And God, lift my heart to see you. God, thank you for meeting me here, right now, where I am, just as I am, in your grace. God, teach me to rest in you, to abide in you, to be faithful in simplicity. God, teach me the value of prayer, the power of union and communion in Christ, praying in Christ's name, abiding in Him, knowing that you see me, and you know me, and you hear me, and you love me. Oh God, I know that you hear my voice, and God, I know that you see our needs. God, teach me that your Spirit is an active Spirit, working in my life, powerful, and you are present with me, and in me. Teach me to pray in spirit and truth. Teach me to believe, as a child, as of a grain of mustard seed, with the simplicity of faith, looking to my Father in heaven. Teach me to ask in confident faith. God, teach me faith, how faith is the way. Teach me to know you. God, teach me to know you. Teach me to hear you, to be led by you, to know your word, to understand your heart, to understand your will, to hear your spirit, that I could know you both personally and theologically, that I may know you and the power of your resurrection, to know the power of your spirit filling me, communing within me. God, help me to know you. God, give me understanding, wisdom. Teach me your heart, as my Father, and teach me your way. God, teach me to be filled with your Spirit, resting in Christ, crucified with Christ, raised with Christ, that I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me, that I need not be cast down, that my faults are crucified, that I live in your life, in your purpose, in your power, in the identity of the new man, not the condemnation of the old. Renew me, refresh me, enliven me, compel me, guide my vision and my heart. God, thank you for your unsearchable grace. Thank you for love. Let me be filled with your love, renewed in your love, resting in your love, compelled by your love. God, thank you for the value you place on needful souls, sinful hearts. Lord, you are so great, so awesome, so holy. I am not worthy to have you enter my house, and yet you would dine with us. You have humbled yourself for us. You reconcile our hearts. You make all things new. Your mercy is new. Your compassion never fails. Only say the word and we are healed. God, I know that all things are possible for the one who believes. Lord, I believe, but help my unbelief. Renew me and refresh me in your life-giving, gracious, powerful Spirit, day by day. Wash away all iniquity, give the cleansing of your word, and give the life of your Spirit. Create in me a pure heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit within me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation. Grant me a willing spirit to sustain me, and bless me to help others in your way, that they also may turn to you. My sacrifice, O God, is a broken and contrite spirit, a broken and contrite heart, you, God, will not despise. God, be welcomed in my heart, may I receive you, not in striving or condemnation, but with joy and celebration and renewal and hope, that I may rest in you, and that I may see the way forward in you. And as I receive you in my heart and home, may I also enter your gates and your presence, to your throne of mercy and grace, with praise and thanksgiving, in the awesome name of Jesus, who is my Savior, my righteousness, my life, my one hope. Thank you, Lord, for daily mercy, unfailing compassion, unlimited love, perfect grace. Thank you for new life. Enliven me again today in your Spirit, in your Word, and in your way. Teach my soul to be trained on you and to praise you. Teach me to live in your presence and in your Spirit. Teach me to live in faith, to walk in faith, to abide in the Spirit of Christ. You are the God of peace, God of shalom. Lord, give us peace and shalom in our hearts, in our lives, in our health, in our relationships, and set us free from things in life that choke out the good seed, the distractions of this world, unnecessary concerns and worries, the stressors that the world would impose on us. Fill me with your life-giving, liberating Spirit. Give me peace. Give me peace in Christ. Give me shalom, in Christ's Spirit, wholeness, wellness, integrity, peace, strength in Spirit. Develop within me the pathways of mind, in your Word. Neuro pathways and brain synapses paved by your Word, that I may learn to think with you, that my mind would be trained on you, and I would not be taken by things outside your will. Seal it for communion and cleansing. Father in heaven who is holy, Father in heaven who is holy, O Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder, and when I think, that God is Son not sparing, sent him to die I scarce can take it in, that on the cross, my burden gladly bearing, he bled and died, to take away my sin. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. O God, thank you for being my Father. O God, worthy is the Lamb. I picture the throne room of heaven. God, you are so holy, so majestic. God, I bow myself down and worship you. You are so far above and beyond myself and so much greater than our world. Jesus, you are so worthy, you are so great, and yet you have humbled yourself for me. You are so worthy of my love and devotion and worship and praise. You are Yahweh. You are the life giver. You are the source of all I need. You are Jesus. You are my Savior. Yesterday, today, tomorrow, you will be faithful always. You make a way. You are the way. Jesus, you are the truth, you are life. Fill us with life today. Fill me with life today. Fill me with your Spirit. Make me an overcomer in every way. Jesus, you have overcome the world, and you live in me. Jesus, you have overcome Satan the devil, our adversary and the relentless accuser of our souls, the enemy of living successfully in Christ's life and victory. Jesus, you give me the victory by your blood and through your word. God, give me the victory, let me live in your victory. Jesus, you have overcome the failure of the flesh, of Adam's life, giving me your Spirit, the Spirit of the new man. God, let me live in the new man today, right now and all day, abiding in you, filled with your purpose. Lord, fulfill your will in me, and my calling in you. Yes, Lord, fulfill your will in me, your calling on my life, my function in your plan, my place and role in the body of Christ, my spiritual gifting, my place in the lives of others, their place in my life. God, let me be driven in the power of your Spirit to live in your calling and your will, for the mission of your gospel, in communities, in our churches, in our families, in the world, in the hearts of people everywhere. Yes, Lord, fulfill your will in me and my calling in you, that I would walk in the steps you have prepared for me. You are the way, you are success, you are victory, Jesus, you are salvation, Yahweh who saves, you have overcome the grave, and you are for me. What, or who, then shall I fear? May Jesus be the name that dominates my life, in whom I live and be, who is with me, whose life renews and empowers me, whose mission becomes my mission, whose peace is my peace, the name above all names. Seal, for the holiness of the Father in heaven, and of the holy name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. God, teach me what it means in the sense that your kingdom is near among us, that we have already been brought into the kingdom of your beloved Son, away from the domain of darkness, with much more than asylum, much more than refuge in your land, but you have given us full citizenship in Christ. We are your people, your children. We are home with you. We belong. We are accepted. I am accepted. And God, teach me what it means that your kingdom is yet to come, already, and not yet, and how we relate to it. Teach me to know what you have graciously given us. And God, may we pray for the move of your gospel in our world, the move of your kingdom on earth. Hasten the day, Lord. May your kingdom be the focus of my life. Lord, hasten the spread of your gospel in truth and grace of Jesus Christ, our Savior and our hope. God, let your kingdom be established among us. Teach me to set godly values, to have a divine perspective, that the values of my life would be the values of your kingdom, that I would establish my purpose in you. Fill us in your church with a sense of living in your kingdom, already and not yet, while we long for the day when your kingdom will be established in whole and in view of the world. Until then, Lord, bring more into your kingdom, and help our church, and all of your churches. Help me to bring new souls and hurting souls into your home and kingdom. Selah, for the kingdom and the will of God. Give us today our daily bread. God, we trust you for today. Speak your word to our hearts for today. We don't know what tomorrow has in store. We don't know what tragedy may befall, or what blessing may be in store. And so we trust you for tomorrow. But God, bless us today. Give us all that we need to live today. Thank you for all that you give and provide. Thank you for every necessity and every luxury. Thank you for food and shelter. Thank you for our jobs and our schools. Seal, for the promises of God, and for his daily provision for life, for the manna I need today. Forgive us, and teach us to forgive as you forgive. God, forgive us. May we never become callous to our need for grace, proud or arrogant in thinking that we stand in our own righteousness, but that we need your grace even in our best moments. Forgive us for what we've done wrong. Forgive us for sinful thoughts. Forgive us for the way we have had the wrong hard attitude toward others and toward events. Forgive us for our lack of faith and presumptuous actions. And help us to forgive others. Help us to be quick in agreeing with your Spirit in your forgiveness of others. Your mercy, long-suffering, patience, kindness, goodness, your grace. Seal, for grace, mercy, kindness, forgiveness, reconciliation. Your will be done, God. Lead us in the right way, away from the traps of the world, away from the tendencies of our flesh, away from the lies of Satan. Help us to see how you are using challenges in our lives to shape us and lead us. God, rebuke my every inclination to go my own way, and revive me in your way. Turn my eyes away from empty longings in Psalm 119, verse 37. But Lord, help me to discern my longings in your wisdom, to know what is of your will. Not my will, but thine. Guide me in how I spend my time. God, I know I need exercise. Please bless that time and bless our health. Bless my schedule. Selah, for the wisdom of God. God bless my family. God, thank you for the beautiful and wonderful companion, and the love, and the gift you have given me in marriage. For the faith adventure of life, and family, and ministry. Bless our relationship together. May we grow in unity more and more. And God bless our children in their individual needs, and in their relationship together. God, thank you for them, and help me please to be the parent they need, and help me to be the spouse I need to be, and can be. Help me in the power and blessing of your dwelling spirit. Selah, for God's blessing on our family. Lead us for each of us, Lord. Lift up our eyes to see you, to understand your perspective for our lives, your will for our lives, that we would not be consumed with serving ourselves, but that we could love others with your love, and be compelled in your mission to seek, and to save those who are lost. Provide for your mission among us, for laborers in the field, for all that is needed in your mission through us, and be with us always, filling us with your Spirit. Lead us from temptation, both me and all believers. Deliver us from evil and from the evil one. Selah, that God would lead us in his way, clear of trial, away from temptation, to guard our hearts in his truth and grace. God, I pause to pray especially for my family and friends, as their names and faces and needs come to mind. For my spouse, and for every need. For my children, their needs and their friends. The families of their friends, their schools, their teachers, their classmates, their learning, their personal formation. And God bless our extended families, parents, siblings, nephews and nieces, our friends, longtime friends, friends in church, our neighbors, co-workers, and God bless our work, our careers, our duties, our vocations and occupations, our income, our budget, our giving, our spending, our expenses. God bless our necessities, and God, thank you for every luxury. God bless the ministry leaders in our church, our pastors and their families, every person who is gifted to the body of Christ, every person whose role and relationship in the body is known by you. and God bless our ministries. The youth and children, the elderly, God bless and heal all who are sick in the congregation. Ministry opportunities. God, we pray to the Lord of the harvest, empower us and send more laborers into the field. Lift our eyes to see the fields of harvest and guide us in ministry of your gospel. God bless our church, every person, every family, every ministry, every sharing of your gospel. Bless our gatherings, the unity and vitality and blessing of the body of Christ, the preaching and teaching of your word, the proclamation of your gospel. God, fill your church with peace and joy in your presence and in your purpose. God, bless all your churches for our city, our state, our nation, and the world. And God, we pray for missions and missionary needs throughout the world, in America, in North America, South America, Dominican, Venezuela, Central America, Africa, Sudan, Uganda, Congo, Western Europe, Rome, Eastern Europe, Russia, Ukraine, the Near and Middle East, Israel, Syria, Iran, Iraq, Afghanistan, East Asia and Southern Asia, India, Pakistan, Cambodia, China, East Gates, missions organizations, theology and mission schools, the next generations of men and women who carry your gospel, fill them with your spirit, raise them up. Fill us with the Spirit, your Spirit, the Spirit of God, the Spirit of Christ, the Spirit who is ever present, who is all powerful, all loving, the Spirit who broods over the world and over our lives, the Spirit who overcomes all things, and guides all things, and is never overpowered by anything, the Spirit who is resurrection, and who seats us right now in Christ at the right hand of the Father in heaven, far above every trouble of earth, the Spirit who has true dominion over the universe, the Spirit who birthed Christ into the world, who filled Christ in the Gospels, the Spirit who raised him from the grave, the Spirit who filled the apostles for new life, and new power, new purpose. The Spirit who raises also me to new life today, and focuses my life's mission, my vision, purpose, values, behavior in new life. The Spirit who pours out the fruit of love, joy, peace, long-suffering, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, temperance, wanting the best for others, knowing the best for myself and every blessing of Christ in the heavenly places, a lasting and abiding and enduring spirit, with spiritual strength, and a song in the heart, and teaching, exhorting, singing, praising, worshiping, abiding in Christ, submitting to one another, serving in love, in peace, in His Spirit, as His love is shed abroad through His Spirit into our hearts. God, quicken us, quicken me today and right now, in the Spirit of Christ, without striving, but resting in Christ, and empowered by Him for the will and the to-do of His will, for me, to me, in me, and through me. Seal, for the power of the indwelling and the filling of the Spirit of God. God, you are so mighty to work in our lives, so gracious, so loving, so kind, so long-suffering, All is yours, Lord, truly yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. God be with us, bless us, keep us, shine the glory of your face and your grace upon us with your eyes of favor. Lift up your countenance upon us and give us peace. Shalom. In Jesus' name we are blessed to say amen. Let it be so for us and for others whom you call us to serve.